Today is the first day of Black History Month, which is celebrated every February in the United States. And Google decided to do something different this month. Today, Google Doodle paid homage to a Black Brazilian activist, Leila Gonzalez. It just so happens that February 1st, today, is also her 85th birthday. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the work and life of Leila Gonzalez, a Black feminist scholar activist from Brazil. You're going to understand why she is so revered among Black Brazilian women. And when I first learned about her a couple of years ago, man, I couldn't believe how far ahead of her time she was. Leila Gonzalez was a Black activist and intellectual who denounced forms of racism and sexism that subjugated Black women. And get this, she was talking about intersectionality before that term even ever existed. Leila Gonzalez was born in 1935 on February 1st in Belo Horizonte, but she moved to Rio de Janeiro with her family because her brother was a professional football player who played for Flamengo. While in Rio, she pursued her studies seriously. She graduated from high school. She attended college, studying history and philosophy. Now, for you, this may seem obvious. Of course, a Black woman is gonna graduate from college. But we're talking about 1950s and 1960s Brazil. Back then, Black people weren't even going to high school. So the fact that you had this Black woman who graduated from high school, got a college degree in the 1960s in Brazil, yo, that is something else. And I can assure you that in all of her classes, she was probably the only Black person. And Leila Gonzalez, after she achieved her education, became a public school teacher. But she didn't stop there. She pursued a master's degree, and she pursued a PhD, and she became a Black intellectual when Black intellectuals did not exist in Brazil, let alone Black woman intellectuals. But as an intellectual, she did not want to limit her knowledge to herself. She wanted to teach it to other people. She came with a point of view that valorized the Africanist of Brazilian culture. And she wanted to spread that love of the Blackness and Africanness of Brazilian culture to other people. So she started teaching it. Not only was she analyzing Black culture and the African contribution to Black culture, but she was also working in this intellectual capacity that tried to analyze feminism along with racism. And you know, back in the day, in the 1960s and 70s, feminism was a very white thing. So to have this Black Brazilian woman who was insisting that we look at these two issues, feminism and racism, and analyze how they affect Black women, that was revolutionary.
Social, né? E o que a gente vai perceber é que na nossa sociedade, quer dizer, as classificações sociais, no caso, a racial, sexual, né? É, entrando aí também, fazem da mulher negra este ser assim, né? Que é objeto de dos mais sérios estereótipos existentes na nossa sociedade.
She was one of the few Black Brazilian intellectuals who were traveling all around the world to attend conferences that would explain her work. And so she would actually meet other Black intellectuals from across Latin America and across the United States. That she actually met Angela Davis at a conference in Baltimore in the late 80s. That's how bold she was. During her time, she published two groups. One was called O Lugar do Negro, and another one, which is probably her most popular and cited book, was called As Festas Populares do Brasil. And this was like a book in which she collected and analyzed all of these popular festivals around Brazil that had a connection to Africa, a connection to Afro-Brazilian culture. And she put it in a book, and that book, it's a pretty rare find these days. Today you gotta pay $100 for the book, and I am determined to get a copy of that book. Leila did not limit her work to academics. She was an activist. she was actually one of the founders of the Black movement in Brazil. In Brazil, people who are involved in fighting for the rights of Black people are generally said to be a part of this Black movement. And this Black movement had its origins in a group called the Movimento Negro Unificado do Brasil. And Leila was one of the founders of this group. In 1994, Leila Gonzalez became the head of the sociology department at Brazil's premier private university, the Catholic University of Rio de Janeiro. Now, let me just explain to you. This happened more than 25 years ago. You had a Black woman who was head of an entire department at an elite university in Brazil. That barely happens in America. So the fact that this woman was doing this in the 90s in Brazil, she was way ahead of her time. Okay, I don't know if saying way ahead of their time is correct, because she should have been there. It's not that she was way ahead of her time, it's just that Black people, it's taken so long for Black people to reach these levels in society, and Leila did it way faster than anybody else. Unfortunately, soon after, Leila Gonzalez suffered a heart attack, and so she died fairly young, at the age of 59, but she had accomplished so much in that short time. Thankfully, her work lives on. In 2018, another book was published of her work, Primavera para as Rosas Negras, and this book compiles her articles, letters, and even interviews with people into a nice handy collection. And in fact, the foreword was actually written by a friend of mine, Raquel Barreto, who was one of the first people to ever complete her master's thesis about Leila Gonzalez. And that was more than 15 years ago. One of my biggest wishes is that the work of Black intellectuals and people like Leila Gonzalez will eventually be translated into English. We've had this barrier for so long between Black Brazilian people and Black Americans, and the only way we'll get over this barrier is if this work is translated into each other's languages. Just in the last 5 years, a lot of the work of some of the premier Black feminist intellectuals like Angela Davis and Patricia Hill Collins has been published in Portuguese. And now it's time to return the favor and publish the work of Black Brazilian feminists and scholars into English. So if you like this video, please like it. Please click on that notification button, because I need all the views that I can get, because we got a lot of videos coming up. It's carnival season and I'm doing my carnival videos right now. And please also follow me on my two Instagram profiles, AfroRealTravel and Kira Tiana. Thank you so much. I look forward to seeing you guys around.